Respected judges, greetings of the day. Myself, Hiral Joshi, along with my teammates, Shrishti Bhamble and Keshav Kumar, will present a poster today on the topic of perspectives on drug development in the treatment of COVID-19. Our main objective of this poster is to highlight the recent development of new antiviral drugs against SARS-CoV-2. Remdesivir is a drug that is developed by Gilead Sciences and US Center for Disease Control and Prevention. It is the only approved antiviral drug for COVID-19. Remdesivir is a prodrug, and this antiviral molecule is an adenosine nucleotide analog which inhibits viral replication by inhibiting the enzyme RNA-dependent RNA polymerase. However, it has a few side effects like constipation, hypoalbuminemia, hypokalemia, anemia, thrombocytopenia, and increased total bilirubin levels. On the other hand, molnupiravir is a new antiviral and a cost-effective drug which is very close to approval in an advanced clinical trial stage. Thus, the approval of a new drug must meet the so-called conditions, like it must be cheap, available in pharmacies for a large population, it should be without side effect and with proven effectiveness. The three methods that are preferred to discover new antivirals in a short period are: first, the de novo design of antivirals; second, the repositioning of the approved drug; third, the virtual screening of known molecules. So now let us look at drugs that are developed by the de novo approach, that is, starting from the very scratch. The first one is molnupiravir, which is a promising antiviral, a prodrug of ribonucleoside analog beta-D N4-hydroxycytidine. It is orally bioavailable, and this new antiviral is in the advanced clinical study stage, which has reached the phase 3 clinical trial studies. And molnupiravir is easy to synthesize in just 3 steps with a yield of 69%. This method is environmentally friendly. The another new and helpful oral antivirus for SARS-CoV-2 has been developed by Pfizer company from scratch, and it acts by inhibiting the infection that causes COVID-19. This new antiviral acts as a reversible covalent inhibitor of main protease of SARS-CoV-2 through cysteine residues. PF07321332 is considered as a potential treatment for the upcoming coronavirus risk. This oral antiviral drug would be given at the first symptoms and patient would not need to be hospitalized. This drug has reached in the phase 1 clinical trial studies. Pfizer company also has reported another drug called as PF07304814, another compound with intravenous administration for already hospitalized victims. So combining both drug number 2 and 3, this can act as a full therapy model for COVID patients. And the third drug is currently in the phase 1B multiple dose trial. Now I hand over the rest of the presentation to my teammates Keshav and Shrishti. Thank you.
So repositioning of the known drugs means where we have already know the existing therapeutic benefit of the drug, but we have found some new therapeutic indication for the particular drug and we have launched the drug into the market. This is the most affordable alternative method for discovering the treatment of COVID-19. The pathophysiology of these drugs include some novel mechanism, like they act by inhibitor of viral activity, or they can be act by modulation of the viral immune reaction. So the very first drug which comes under repositioning of the known drugs, remdesivir. It is the only antiviral drug which is approved for the treatment of COVID-19. And this drug was initially approved for Ebola virus and Marburg virus in infection. These drugs are approved for emergency measure in US, which was approved by FDA. And these drugs act by viral RNA-dependent RNA polymerase. Remdesivir treatment also includes side effects, and these were published by some guidelines, surviving sepsis campaign guidelines. They suggest that remdesivir in non-ventilated patients can treat moderate to severe COVID-19. There was another recent trial conducted using remdesivir where the improvement in rehabilitation of patient in COVID-19. This was the only advantage we have got from remdesivir. There was another drug, favipiravir. It is the only antiviral drug which was approved in Japan for the treatment of influenza and in 2014 it is orally bioavailable, and favipiravir has improved some symptoms like pyrexia and cough. This was the advantage over remdesivir. WHO specialist used 4 drugs for antiviral drugs that can potentially reduce the mortality for patient: lopinavir, hydroxychloroquine, interferon and remdesivir. But it was found that none of the drug reduced the mortality, nor the hospitalization or mechanical ventilation requirement. It is believed that if we reduce the viral load, we can cure the COVID-19. But a clinical trial using a combination of lopinavir, ritonavir, interferon beta-1b and ribavirin, which was conducted, they suggested that increased rate of viral clearance was seen. So conclusion was difficult to outline because there was no placebo group was included in the clinical trial. So thank you. Further, Shushti will continue.
The third strategy was virtual screening using in silico tools that is currently being widely used due to their multiple benefits, like they are cost efficient and they scan multiple compounds simultaneously, which thereby saves the time. It also screens the toxicity of the compounds on the target cells from which it was discovered that azithromycin, which is a new generation antibiotic of the macrolide class, offers a therapeutic window in the treatment of COVID-19. It has been established to have antiviral and immunomodulatory effects, which may be efficacious in the hyperinflammatory syndrome caused in this disease. Azithromycin has also been clinically effective in respiratory distress syndrome and viral infections. Also, niclosamide, which is an anthelmintic drug, and cyclosonide, that is a corticosteroid, was selected as antivirals against SARS-CoV-2 through computational methods. Ivermectin is an antiparasitic drug and was found to interact with viral protein targets using computational methods, where it was proven in a clinical study that ivermectin reduced COVID-19 mortality by 40% as it blocks viral protease, replicase and human TMPRSS2 due to its sturdy hydrophobic linkage. It binds better with the proteins of interest than remdesivir. Several drugs were shown to inhibit the primary protease enzyme of the virus in a computational drug repositioning study. Among them are carfilzomib and valbrubicin. They are approved anti-cancer drugs. Eravacycline, which is a new antibiotic in the tetracycline class used to treat intra-abdominal infections. Elbasavir, that is an antiviral which was used to treat chronic hepatitis C. Now, in vitro and in vivo studies are needed in the future to confirm the effectiveness of these drugs. To summarize the presentation, significant investments for the development of new antivirals have been missing for COVID virus, as the focus being mainly on developed and developing vaccines. A global effort is hence needed to develop new effective antiviral drugs in order to prevent another similar global pandemic situation. Comparing 3 strategies for developing new antiviral compounds, the first one was de novo design. It is time and resource consuming, and a faster approach is hence needed. So the second approach, repositioning of available drug, is a desirable alternative. Also, virtual screening is a modern alternative with many benefits, among the most crucial being the decreasing of cost and the lesser time for identification of lead compounds with potential in the regimens of COVID-19. Thank you.